Want to know how to get clean, sharp engravings like this on glass with the xTool F1 Ultra? Let's go step by step. The trick is giving the laser something it can bite into. I'll be using Rust-Oleum chalk spray paint as my marking layer. It's cheap, easy to find, and it adheres to glass really well. Before spraying, I wipe the glass down with rubbing alcohol. This removes grease or fingerprints so the paint sticks evenly. Don't mind the Mr. Sheen bottle, it's because I keep on bumping the bottle over, so this just keeps spillages to a minimum. Just a thin, even coat is all you need. Too thick and you'll get uneven burning. Now we just let it dry for about 15 minutes before engraving. So for engraving round objects like glasses, I'll be using the RA2 Pro rotary attachment. If you've been following me for a while, you'll know I'm all about repeatable, consistent results. That's why I use this simple homemade 6mm MDF guide to position my RA2 Pro. It means I can quickly repeat engravings perfectly on multiple glasses. You just drop straight in, no measuring, no fuss. With the rotary set up, I can mount the glass securely and get ready to focus. The xTool F1 Ultra does have autofocus, which is very convenient, but not always perfect. So after final positioning, I will set the final little bit of measurement manually. With a stop screw in place, it won't budge, keeping my rotary perfectly aligned for consistent results. A quick manual adjustment brings the laser exactly into focus. That small tweak makes a big difference in engraving clarity. Next, I measure the diameter of the glass so I can enter the exact size into the software. Before engraving the final design, I always run a test grid to dial in the settings perfectly. The cost of an extra glass here will pay for itself down the line by preventing the hassle of fault finding in the middle of a batch job. Preparation is always better than putting out fires later on. I use 140 lines per centimeter for glass. It gives a smooth, even finish without building up too much heat in one spot. Now let's run the test grid. Each square is a different speed and power setting, so we can see exactly how the glass responds. Before engraving, I warm the glass with a hairdryer. This prevents the localized heat of the laser from cracking the glass if the ambient temperature is too low. Once it's finished, I check the grid under normal light to see which settings gave the cleanest, sharpest result. Under the microscope, you can really see the difference. Some settings look faint, others are too harsh and chip the glass. But one or two hit that sweet spot with an even frosted finish. Where you see this cracking here, this you will hear when it's in the laser. If you hear a plinking, almost cracking sound, back off on your power or your speed is too slow for the power settings you're using. This will seriously affect what it actually looks like in the end. With the test settings result in, I load my design into XES and lock in the winning speed, power and line settings. Now it is time to run the final engraving. Here's the engraving straight out of the machine, still covered with paint. The paint washes off easily with warm water and a sponge, leaving the engraving crisp and clean. And here it is, a perfectly engraved glass of the xTool F1 Ultra. Clean, sharp and repeatable results every time. If you'd like to try this design yourself, check out my shop on Design Find, and if you need help preparing files for your own laser projects, connect with me on Fiverr. Links are below. Cheers, everyone.